for the mere fact that you are doing it, this is your purpose and your meaning. You just got to take the shit more serious. You, what I'm trying to say is sometimes we hear, but we don't register. We don't process. So when I say you are the ones that are fortunate enough to tap into this knowledge when the whole world is crazy, you need to process that for a minute and understand the importance of that. First of all, the greatest thing on the planet is the knowledge of self and basically the knowledge of the universe. For you, for the mere fact that you are even interested in this or remotely interested in this at this particular time when shit is going on crazy out here, it means that you are the special evolved beings. And so when I'm saying you need to process, you got to process that everything that you read in these books that you admire about the gods in the heaven and the gods in the universe, you must understand that that is nobody but you at this particular time. There's two realms of gods. That's the one that's dead, laying out like the body of Osiris. And there's the ones that's dead, but they're dead physically as far as this physical body does not make them, they're not able to do the things that they once used to do when they were gods. But you are not dead mentally because you are rising up. And for the mere fact that you are trying to understand, you're trying to get this knowledge, trying to get this, and you're trying to understand the meaning of it all, that means your spirit is going through a ritual. You just take any adventure story. And you know, they had to fight this particular person, they had to fight this particular person, and at the end of the movie, they get what they're supposed to get, and they are glorified. That's what's going on with you now as your struggle. So we had the mystery system that was in the last days. You had the mystery system. But the mystery systems are now closed down, and now your initiation that you become God is in your struggle. So for the mere fact that you are catching hell and going through this struggle, it's a form of initiation. But you must understand that what I'm saying to you is that the ones that the whole world is looking towards at this particular time, first of all, they're looking for the black people on the earth, the last realm of the spear of the Kabbalah. Let me put this up. For those people know, we go for the long haul. For the ones that have to leave, we give you knowledge, you get full up, and you know you leave, and if you miss, you always can come back and get the tape. For the ones that want to stay, people know who's been to the lectures and all. We don't let out early and all, you know, and stuff. But the point is what I'm trying to make here is the realm, you got to understand the concept of the God that you are searching for is yourself. And the God that everybody is depending on at this particular time is a few people in Atlanta, which is you. A few people in New York, a few people in Philadelphia, a few people in Chicago, a few people in all the major cities, which is less than 1%, and a few people scattered out in the rural areas. And those are the light bringers that you're talking about, the great old ones. So you have to understand this concept. The other concept you got to understand, a God, whatever you do as a God, there is no chastisement for it. I'll explain to you. You got to stop thinking like a human and start thinking like a God. You see which one to cry on? Stop thinking like a human. You got to start thinking as a God. G-O-D, generator, operator, and destroyer. Is it not written in your law that ye are gods? John chapter 10, verse 34, 35. You know the whole deal. You have to start thinking this way because, okay, here it is. You have to start thinking this way because I'm telling you, the reason, what is the holdup is that the actual gods do not realize they're gods. There's a good movie you need to get. There's a good movie you need to get. You need to get a movie called A Never Ending Story. You thought it was a child movie. And he gets this little book and he goes through this adventure. And at the end of the movie, midway of the movie, they say, hell, coming to find out that the little boy that was reading the book of all these magnificent heroes, the other boy on the other side who was going through all the trial was him. And they said, at the end they said, well, hell, our world is falling down because he doesn't believe in himself. It's all about you. That's the key. That's the key. This is the real knowledge. There's a mystery of the world, and the mystery of the world is look for no God to save you but yourself because it's within you. It's within you. It's just that the devil came down about 2,000 years ago, basically, when we get into this, and he made you start worshiping him so you would not cultivate the energy within you. And that's your slavery and your real bondage. And this is the key what we have to deal with here. Because, I mean, we go through, we see things on TV and we see this shit and we say, when is this shit over with? But the key is, in the 60s, we didn't have this knowledge. In the 70s, we didn't have this knowledge. In most of the 80s, we didn't have this knowledge. You see what I'm saying? We only had a few people talking about it in the past years before that, and we all thought they were crazy. But now, we have the knowledge. As a matter of fact, some people saying, you know, they say things like, too much knowledge is dangerous to the untrained ear. That's not true. What is happening here is this. The knowledge is here. Now, there is no more secrets. There is no more secret societies that's holding back knowledge. You see, the white boy understood that they would keep people dead long enough until they would be so dead, until there would come a time where they would be so much immersed in ignorance until they can give them knowledge and they will reject knowledge. And that's when he start putting out all the knowledge. That's why you go to your family members and they reject the shit. And mainly you. So they know that most black people reject this. I don't want to hear that black shit. I don't want to hear that shit, that old crazy voodoo shit. So because they reject it, now they can put the stuff out. So there is no more such thing as secrets. The secrets is that the masses of the people hate knowledge. You understand what I'm saying? So as up around 1985, they knew that the people would reject knowledge because they knew you rejected it in the 70s and the 60s. So they said, now we can put all the stuff out that we had held for the last 140 years that we dug up around the world. And as a result, that's why we only have less than 1% of the amount of people that really bears witness to what the hell is going on, you see. So as we say, let's see, let me get this right. Yeah, we don't need a big thing, just need enough. When you're dealing with the, let's open up my bag. And when you're dealing with the, I got to pour libations. I'm getting ahead of myself, but, you know, while stuff is on your mind, it's best to say it before you get too far in it. And, you know, so when you're dealing with the spear of the Kabbalah, and there's several spears of the Kabbalah, which is nothing but your physical body is the real mystery behind this, is your physical body. There's several trees of life. Everybody can see this? There's several trees of life. This is the heaven realm. And all these realms are on their way down to here. Because this is called Malkuth. Malkuth, the daughter. Can you see it? You can't see it at all.
Bump it up.
Huh? Make it bigger. Okay, hold up. In order to make it bigger, let's see, we're going to have to go back. Let's see. Let's see how far we can go back with this thing. Let's see here what we can do. What's on this other side here? Nope. That's dim. Okay, there we go. Now, all I have to do now is either push it up. Nope. Push it back. Now, we you know. You can't see it at all on the screen yet? Hmm? Huh? What, these? Oh, yeah, hit the...
Hmm?
Yeah. 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 There you go. Now, that means that you must understand that everything here, which is Mars, Saturn, Jupiter, the moon, the sun, all of the spheres is going to end up right here at the bottom sphere, which is you. So that means all the energy in the universe is going to come within you and on the earth realm. So that's when they say that the gods in heaven, the man on earth say God is on high, but the angels in heaven say that God lives on earth. That means that everything is waiting on one group of people, the lost nation of Israel, or what you would just call basically, because all of Israel is lost, Isis, Ra, and El, which just means black people, and all black people are lost, from Maine to Spain, from damn Africa to Russia, because we got black people in all those places. Basically, they're talking about the ancient race, and that one seed. So when you're talking about this, the whole universe now is waiting on you. And they're especially waiting, and they know that the masses of those are dead. So that means there's only one people in the universe that's the most important now, and that's the black people that's waiting now. And basically, that's what you have with the little small cluster in one small community. in the United States of America, basically because the knowledge is here more than it is other places. Other places are not privy to the knowledge. They can't go to a bookstore and buy the actual knowledge or rent videos and different things. So whether we're taking advantage or not, the knowledge is here, so we're talking about you. And that's the key when we're talking about the Christ form. So what we're going to do is we're going to post for the libations. And remember now, I tell you what, I'm going to give out my damn phone number. So y'all call me, let's see, that's my shit due on the 5th. Y'all call me on the 5th and ask me, say, well, listen, did you make your rent? So if you're concerned and all, and I'll let you know, well, okay, cool, I did it and all, whatever the deal is. But I'm going to give out my phone number so that way, you know, whatever the deal is. If you can't provide me with anything, tell me a space or something I can go and squat in and shit, whatever the deal is. Now, so basically, what we're going to do is we're going to turn to this particular page in this book. And I always use this one because it's going to be on page, this book, A Kabbalah for a Modern World. And we'll explain. This is the Tree of Life. Most people, when they start studying the Kabbalah, they're just thinking it's this. But this is just the formation of the book. And so A Kabbalah of a Modern World, which is actually talking about the energies within your body, which is the mystery. In here, they have a list of the gods that correspond to each other. So I like to use this one. And also, where's my water? Okay, this is cool. All right, you know the drill. Did you got any more ancient shining ones, or you sold out?
I have
more about Yeah. Keva, Ashe, Shakma. I say Bina, I say Jesed, I say Deborah, I say Tipperet, I say Noxod, I say Hard, I say Yased, I say Dark, I say Malkut, I say Ain, I say Ain Saw Ur, I say Osea, I say Aset, I say Tahuti, I say Mayat, I say Ptah, I say Sut, I say Ra, I say Amun Ra, I say Anpu, I say Hetheru, I say Aset, I say Nebhert, I say, let's see, Kinti Amenti, I say Kinti Erti, I say Kephra, I say Cones, I say Earthris, I say Amuthis, I say Raheru Kahuti, I say Hopacrots, I say Heru Raha, I say Mim, I say Minibeth, I say Muntu, I say Mentu, I say Sashet, I say Sekhmet, I say Selket, I say Vashashetu, I say, okay, Aether, I say Uraeus, I say Rhea, I say Zeus, I say Ares, I say Apollo, I say Aphrodite, I say Hermes, I say Demetrius, I say Demeter, I say Yima, I say Odin, I say Frigda, I say Balder, I say Laki, I say Thor, I say Freya, I say Freya, I say Thur, I say Nerthris, I say Brahmin, I say Vishnu, I say Bravini, I say Ramachandra, I say Shakti, I say Sita, I say Indra, I say Sita, I say Hanuman, I say Lakshmi, I say Buddha, I say Krishna, I say Damawalawedo, I say Marasha, I say Bridget, I say Adin Gwerdi, I say Ogu Ferelli, I say Ogu Shango, I say Azuli, I say Legba, I say Edoedo, I say Zaka, I say Papagede, I say, okay, Oshosi, I say Ogun, I say Obatala, I say Ishu, I say Alafi, I say Adudawa, I say Arunla, I say Ogun, I say Shango, I say Oshun, I say Legba, I say Imenja, I say Arisha Oko, I say Oya, I say put that there. Huh? What you said? I say, Babaluaye. I say, Olakun. I say, okay. Ife. I say, Loa. I say, what's that?
Ori.
I say, Orishas, let's say. I say, okay, now, that's the ones in there. Let's see if we think of some more right now. Raziel, I say Haniel, I say Bubiel, I say Lachmiel, I say Gabriel, I say Elijah, I say Atom, I say Atan, I say Atom Gordi, I say, let's see, Okumi, I say Kutumi, I say Shanat Kumara, I say Melchizedek, I say Sutek, I say Sut, I say Sutnebit, I say Sutnusi, Sutnubit, I say Suthar, I say Nut, I say Apit, I say Tyre, I say Layla, I say Gaia, I say Marduk, I say Tiamat, I say Rastafari, I say Cthulhu, I say Hastar, I say Aldathoth, I say Yog-Sothoth, I say Nilahotep, I say Dagon, I say Shub-Niggurath, I say Great Old Ones, I say Great Ones, I say let's keep on. I say Elijah Muhammad, I say I'm going to get these in. Thunder dog, I say thunderbird, I say great sun bear, I say white buffalo, I say patanetta unra, I say. Okay, give me some more. Awas, I say. Muawas, I say. Muaybas, I say. Obas, I say. I say. Tupac Shakur, I say. I say. Give me some more. Well, you say, okay, let's do these for the ancestors. For all gods known and unknown, I say. Okay, the Shaw family, I say. The Hemmitt family, I say. The Davis family, I say. All my family members, I say. Okay, now when I count three, one, two, three, start calling out your ancestors. One, two, three. Ashe, 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 Ashe. To all gods known and unknown, Ashe. To all ancestors known and unknown, Ashe. Okay, now we got that out of the way. Remember, like I said, the main book that you want to get that's going to give you all the gods from around the world is Ancient Shining One, DJ Conway, which might I add is a woman, come to find out. DJ Conway is a woman also, too. We want to deal with those things. Okay, we want to, let's see what we're going to do. Okay, this is the one we're going to do here. Let's see. Okay, here it is. This is what we want to do. This is one aspect of assuming the Christ form, which is a ritual. Which, if you all want to stand and do this, this is like putting energy in yourself and assuming the Christ which is in you. So that's like tapping into the melanin. For those people who want to participate, just stand up right quick and we just read this thing and you repeat after me. You ready? Hear me, O Lord.
Hear me, O Lord.
Thou art the first and the last.
Thou art the first and the last.
The beginning and the end.
The beginning and the end.
The Alpha and the Omega.
Who are the nameless and the formless ones?
Creator of all.
Lord of light.
Lord of life.
Lord of love.
Hear my prayer.
Thou true son and daughter.
And I ask that thou look with favor upon this ritual.
Of the assumption of the heavenly Christ.
Aid me in my becoming.
I seek rebirth in thy light.
Aid me in my becoming.
I seek perfection in thy sight.
Aid me in my becoming.
Clothe me in white raiment.
In my crown of gold. No, excuse me. Let's see. Crown me with gold. Set me upon the throne of mercy. And with the white horse of judgment. Into my right hand place the scepter of rule. In my left hand place the sword of law. Anoint me with my secret names of power.
So let it be.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Okay, now that's pretty badass ritual there. I'm gonna sell these babies for like $2. And it's about seven. That's just one aspect. There's about seven pages, and it goes through this whole thing, and it gives you all the different names of your particular Christ energy names and stuff. Because the Christ who is to come is within you. Whether it be Obatala in Yoruba, whether it be Ishu in Yoruba, whether it be also that would be also in Vodun, whether it would be the Christos in Greece, the Christ in Egypt, the Christ in Egypt, the Buddha in Hinduism, the buffalo, the white buffalo is a form of the Christ in Native American, and whether all around the world. And that's the problem that we got here is the devil came in and told you of a historical Christ who did not exist. And that's the problem that we have at this particular time. So now let me go through some things that's going on, because you know it's a beautiful day. And see, the thing about it is the white boy knew back in April that white people had started asking this question, saying this is some bullshit. So they came out and had scholars in Newsweek, Time, and USA Today talking about the search of Jesus. Who was he? And he still got that crack on here in 1996, you see what I'm saying? Who is he? his life and his meanings. So what it means is, and they got all these scholars trying to say that he did exist. You see what I'm saying? That's the reason. We're going to explain that. If people have problems with that, we need to explain that to the fullest. You see what I'm saying? Because that is a political move to take the gnosis or the knowledge or the light from the ancient people and put them in slavery. And that's what it is. And so we're going to deal with that particular part also, too. So right now what I'm going to do is, we're going to go through a little bit of, what's that? Oh, that reminds me, too. Okay. Yeah, so let's go into some things. First of all, a brother got a channel from Tupac. He got a channel from Tupac, and it's interesting. Soon as he was released from the physical body, he knew all his ancient knowledge, and he came down and was talking as what happens. The physical body is what keeps you locked in where you don't know the knowledge. So soon as he was released, he knew a certain amount of knowledge, and he came to this brother, was telling the brother, hey, man, there is no more such thing as a time is over. It's just a matter of when the damn room get filled up. You see what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's like if it's over and somebody done brought in the damn fish tank, you're just waiting for the fish tank to get filled up so it don't correspond with physical dates, because you can't really put a date on it, but you can understand the season, and we are in it now, and it's damn near over. You can tell when you're getting closer to the door. You know what I'm saying? So that's what's going on here. Same way I can tell when it's closer to rent time and shit. But anyway, he said that, but I'm going to tell you one of the other reasons about Tupac is Tupac kind of, Tupac said himself when he told the sister, he said, well, I got killed based on my ego. And it's interesting because now all of a sudden they're trying to deify him and stuff like this. And we always do that. You see, try to deify people and stuff. And saying, you know what, well, he could have been another Malcolm X. Now listen, be realistic about this shit. Tupac Shakur was as far as them from being another Malcolm X as a hog from the damn moon. But anyway, what happened was with Tupac is Tupac, he had a certain amount of energy with him that kept him alive because he got shot all up the last time. But people don't know this. In June, the guards say, okay, you on your own, because Tupac did something that other rap artists never did before. And that was Tupac made a damn video in the back seat with Jodeci, in the back seat of a limo with all these goddamn white women all over his ass. All over his ass. And he got called on it, and he rushed back in and did another video of the same song where he got these black women on stage and him and Jodeci on stage. But where Tupac messed up was Tupac was in the back of a damn limousine with all these white women all over his ass. Anybody saw this video? So what the hell is going on here? You got to realize one thing about the rap culture. One thing you can say about the rap culture, they never was that whole Prince interracial type bullshit. You know what I'm saying? They would have white people in the video, like they have a pool party. You know, you invite there's some white girls that come over, because in real life, you have a party, you might have some white people that come over, you know what I'm saying, and y'all getting, you know, they have a party going on, you know, you got a club, you got white people up in there. So you notice they always did that, but none of the rappers ever really got intimate with these white women or whatever type thing. So when he was in the back of that doggone limousine, it showed the intimacy. And he got called on it because he rushed back in and the video played for about a month. And then he rushed back in and he had to change and do the same song. So, you know, sometimes they do another video, it's a dub mix, or you know, but he did the same song over and I said, oh, he got called on it. You see what I'm saying? So even though he got called on it, it showed the true essence of how some of our people are when they talk all the talk and don't walk the walk. You see what I'm saying? Ain't no way in hell you won't talk and talk about how he said about the ghetto and all this kind of thing. But ain't nobody showing that video when he was around here with them doggone crackers all up in the back seat of his damn car, hooking up with them damn white women. You see what I'm saying? And so as a result of that, the spirits backed off from his ass. And so the next time they pulled up on him, he didn't have the energy. And it was interesting because one brother said that the brother needed a certain amount of spiritual essence around him. And see, all that damn counting money, and I got this many holes, and I got this much stuff, that shit ain't working no more. You see what I'm saying? So we can say all we want about it, because naturally we say good things about people when they dead. But that's not reality. And the reality is Tupac crossed the line with the spiritual world when he fucked up and put that beast in the backseat of the car. Why? Because we understand that rap music has the impulse of the black youth. And rap is doing good for one reason. There's a lot of negative things that went on with rap, but you must understand this part about rap. The rappers never really had all them damn white women around them. Our funk stars and rock and roll stars and all them blues stars, they always had them. Because they complained about Cameo back in 1986. They had that word up. They had all these white women in the damn video. But my point is the rappers came in because it was not associated with being hard. You understand what I'm saying? And having the doggone little Betty from goddamn Buckhead in your shit. Excuse the expression. So what happened was is when he did that, that crossed the line. Even your boy, when he was shaking the booty and all this kind of thing, here your boy from Miami. He's just, and even though we know that it did defile the black woman, they didn't have that white woman up in there. You see what I'm saying? It's one thing to have that beast up in your stuff. What message is that giving to a little boy? Now, Tupac is the number where everybody loves him. It's just one thing to have a rapper that nobody know about. But here's a man that everybody loves, and you're going to go and put this video out with all these white women in your stuff. What message is this sending? You see what I'm saying? And you know what? Isn't it funny? Now, shit is actually beginning to, we say something one month. Next month, stuff is starting to doggone bear witness. So we said that they was going to raise up both Dennis Rodman and your other boy, RuPaul. And now both of them got TV shows coming on. RuPaul got a TV show coming on VH1. And Dennis Rodman has one coming on this fall on MTV. You see, they're raising up the big freak type thing. Yeah, plus, you know, on the first RuPaul show, what are you doing? He kissing Dennis Rodman. Now, what kind of symbolism is that? A black man in 1996, two black men on the damn TV kissing each other. That's some foul stuff. And you know what I'm saying? And we're not talking about, and we're not in the job of bashing somebody for their sexual preference and stuff, because really, in actuality, the gods and the whole thing down here is fucked up, period. There ain't no moralism, ain't nothing down here, but the key is we understand the blueprint on what the white man is trying to do. You see what I'm saying? What the white man is trying to do. Now you see every doggone, every time you turn around, like they say, they got the sisters freaking in every doggone thing. You see what I'm saying? So that's interesting too. Now it's interesting because we got some new information. First of all, we know that the whole OJ thing is back. Now I told you, and it's funny, and this is the funny part about how stuff play out. Now I told you last year that we had found that the OJ Simpson trial, let me see if I can find this book. I think I put it in here. The O.J. Simpson was an ancient trial that they talked about, this great trial that would be held in Egypt in the last days, where they would try to mess the credibility of the black man up. So don't look at O.J. as the figure. Black people was on trial, right? And so this ancient trial, it was verbatim, but it was interesting because and this trial that they talk about, which is in the section of this book. In this book, which is a valuable book from Fetish the God of Ancient Egypt by E. Wallace Budge. In the back of this book, they have papyruses out of the British Museum. This is the last book of his life, Budge. And so he decided to give up all these papyruses that he was actually writing all his books from. So in the back of this book, there's several papyrus, like the wing, this, the Heru of Edfu, which is talking about if you didn't have the melanin, they cut off your head, which you get the movie Highlander from. You see what I'm saying? They say only one can be the Highlander, the blood of kings running through you. So in this particular section of the papyrus in the back of this book, then when you see the legend of Heru Behutet, of the winged disc of Edfu, they're talking about if you didn't have that black dot, they would cut off your head. And in the legend of Heru Behutet, is an ancient word for melanin. It means the black dot or the black circle that we're talking about here. Or the black dot or the black circle, which we give a figure of the Gnostic Christ, Abraxas, and it gives you the black dot also right here, and the wings and the kundalini energy and all of this too, which we have several things of the black dot. And like I said, I always like to put this one up here because, you know, that's how your spirit looks outside of the body. And like I said before, some of you people, you might have seen some of these things some night, and you see a black silhouette and stuff. That's actually a person. And it can take different forms and stuff, but that's how you look. And so based on the people in England, based on the occultists in England, they're saying if you don't look like this, then in actuality you ain't real or you ain't the gods. So therefore we know how that is. But listen. But we do know that in here there's a trial in the part called the Contendings of Horus and Set, wherever you want to go, the Contendings of Horus and Set, and in there, there's a chair here if you want to, but whatever. In here, in the Contendings of Horus and Set, they talk about an ancient trial. But it's interesting now, as so, the devil in here, which is the doggone white boy, he loses the trial. Just as on August the 3rd of 1995, he lost the trial because, number one, that's 10 and 3, which is 13, which is his unlucky number in the first damn place. But anyway, he lost the trial. But in the back of the book, they said that he begs the people, he begs the gods. When the devil loses, he said, no, I want a second trial. Now, what are the odds of that shit? Say, I want a second trial, which he ends up losing anyway. So it don't necessarily mean that necessarily mean that O.J. is going to win the trial. But what it does mean is that basically, this second trial is showing you that this beast is so much of a beast that he can't forget certain amount of things. Now, in 1936 or 35 or 36, they had another crime of the century where they killed this white boy, that Jew boy, for the Lindbergh baby. Now they brought this movie out, The Crime of the Century, and where the white boy literally killed this person because they needed somebody, and because he was this Jew person that they didn't like. Now, isn't it funny that almost, 60 years later, they would have another trial, you see what I'm saying, of the same magnitude, and call it the trial of the century, and that was called the crime of the century. You see, very, very key, and nothing is by chance when they do certain amount of things like that. Nothing is by chance. But isn't it funny how these people cannot bring themselves to believe that this man is innocent? You see what I'm saying? It's innocent. The reason why they can't bring themselves to believe this man is innocent, because they can't bring themselves to believe that they're so arrogant to say that no one could ever plant evidence. Although they can make movies about their white boys and little children getting planted and getting framed by the police, but a black man can't be framed. That's what you're talking about, a sociopathic type of incident. Now, the key to this thing is that we got new evidence that's actually going on, and the new evidence is that what you're dealing with here is that the main person that was involved in the killing was actually Cato Kalin. This is the new shit. Cato Kalin is the one that gave him the gloves, gave him the boots, and gave him all the stuff. You see what I'm saying? And also, we understand that he did this particular information. He gave him this particular information for the simple fact that he was planted there in the get-go to do the whole nine yards and cooperate with the police. That's how they knocked on the door. He's the one that put the bloody sock in the living room. Cato Kalin is the biggest part of this thing. But what the government did and what they do to fool you, they made Cato Kalin as he's this dunce, this homeless house fella. You see what I'm saying? That's just like this valley boy that's stupid. See, they always do this to throw you off. See, that's what they did when they give you a Bill Clinton. They say he's stupid and all this kind of thing, and they do this stuff to throw you off. You see what I'm saying? So you're thinking, okay, he's a so stupid homeless person. He's the main person around this thing. So like I said before, they released the movie The Chase, which we have to go in. And you need to go to the public library, and you need to find out. You look on the Friday edition. You look on the Friday edition, let's say somewhere around June or April. And you need to find out when was the movie The Chase that starred, Charlie Sheen. You need to find out when did this movie actually come out, because this particular movie came out, I think, a month before the actual chase scene of the Bronco. You see what I'm saying? And a month before, Nicole died. You see what I'm saying? And then what happened? Well, he's being chased, and they got the TV cameras and all this, and then what happened? They say, he said, I was accused of something I didn't do. I was an innocent person. He said, what happened? He said, but they accused me, and I got time, because they expected O.J. Simpson to get time. That was the guards that intervened. He said, I got time because I had a cut on my hand, and they took the DNA from the cut on my hand and convicted me. Now, what are the odds? It's no coincidence. What are the odds of they having this movie come out, and he's getting convicted with the cut on his hand, and they got the chase scene in the movie cameras, which the movie came out? How can they, this cracker can take a movie and actually make a movie of what he's going to do a month before, release it a month before, and then do the exact same thing the next month? You see what I'm saying? So he did this, and in this particular movie, what makes this movie authentic is that who was supposed to be the best man at Charlie Sheen, the star of this movie's wedding? Cato Kalin. See what I'm saying? So now the movie goes out of just a theory type thing, and you're just putting two and two together to a reality that it was a setup from the get-go. And Cato Kalin is the doggone key. You see what I'm saying? On Sider, he was screwing around with Nicole and stuff, you know. But hell, she screwed Faye Resnick and all this kind of shit. So who the fuck is she? You know what I'm saying? And all this type of stuff. So the whole thing was set up. And so that movie, The Chase. Also, there's certain things that you got to understand in investigative reporting. Another movie, Natural Born Killers, came out the same. It came out about a month or 3 weeks after The Killing. Came out like the 1st of August. You go to the, periodicals, and you get the newspaper periodicals, and you can go to the movie section and find out when is the release dates of The Chase and Natural Born Killers. So it came out around August. Now, it's interesting about this movie, we would not even ever have thought about this movie, because when I saw the movie when it first came out, and it didn't register until I saw the movie on cable about a month ago. Now, here's a movie that comes out in August, a month after the killing. He hadn't even gone to trial yet, but yet they will flash his picture along with Charles Manson's picture. Now, wait a minute. So most of the people will look, and so people will look now and say, oh, they got OJ up there, and they don't know about the release date. Now, it's funny if the movie came out this year and they did it. You understand what I'm saying? Because we know they're bitter about the trial. But how are you going to put this man as a mass murderer up against Charles Manson? You understand what I'm saying? The brother fell out. Oh, man. Let's see what happened. I think the brother fell out back there. Huh? Is he out? Cut your tape for a minute. Is he all right? Let the brother sit down. He might have just got dizzy from standing up. Or then again, it might be the energy, too. Yeah, you need to go outside, brother. Are you all right? You think it's because of the, you standing up? It's, you know. Yeah. You might have just, you know, sometimes when you stand up like that, you know, hell, I get weak like that, too. You know, whatever. Get you some water or whatever. Then come on back, brother. You know. You see. If you want to go outside or you want to come back or whatever, you know. Yeah, that's, you know, sometimes standing up like that, you know. Just, you know. Or you can get a brother a seat, whatever. Or you can cut it back on. You cut it back on. You got it back on? So what I'm trying to say here is, what are the odds of them convicting this man and putting him against, the magnitude of putting him against doggone Charles Manson before the trial even started? You see what I'm saying? Before the trial even started. The movie Just Cause. So they had the movie Just Cause, and both Sean Connery and the guy Blair Underwood argued that, no, we didn't do this movie based on the O.J. Simpson trial because the book was written in 1982. Right, 1992. Right, but we understood that the whole thing, the O.J. Simpson thing, was nothing but a trial basis that spurned, and it was the second part of the Rodney King verdict in 1992. So if they went to work on this book, you got to understand that all these movies came out at the same time, and that's a whole system that they got, basically trying to undermine black life in America, because one thing about black life, up until recently, black people was the moral authority of America, period. Even white people, if they say, well, we can't get shit to stick now, let's put some Negroes in it. You see what I'm saying? Because we went to church more than anybody else. So the key is to make the black person this particular freak, so therefore they can do what the hell they want to do with black people in the future. You see what I'm saying? So this is interesting, this particularly interesting, but the movie The Chase is the movie that you need to see, which is documenting that the whole Cato Kalin, which was the best friend of Charlie Sheen, was all in on this movie. And that was the key movie to let you know on what they were going to do. They came around again, so they're always testing the market. So they came around again last year. We're just doing some recap, and they said, well, now we know we got black people. Because they did something last year that was the most advanced and the most advanced thing that they could ever do. And that was to release the movie Outbreak 1 week, and 2 weeks later they actually have the outbreak of Ebola. Now what are the odds of that? And nobody even questioned it. So they do these to have a reaction from most of the people, because most of the people are not in consciousness. That's why you got to understand the beauty of the brothers and sisters that's in consciousness is It goes beyond just you being God's and nobody else. It goes beyond to say that it is because of you that the race has a chance. Although everything is going to be redeemed anyway. That's prophesied. But you got to understand, in the form of the redemption of us going to the higher levels, the whole race being redeemed, there's a group of people that is sent down to be the helpers. And those group of people, if you don't get anything, the reason why shit is holding back is because the ones in consciousness do not understand it. You are those people. That's the deal. You see what I'm saying? So now, instead of feeling good about your career and whether I made it, whether I got enough money, that's superficial shit, which is nothing anyway. Idiots have money. You see what I'm saying? The most diabolical people in the world have so-called, quote-unquote, made it. But the most important people on the planet is the one that received this knowledge to get the people out of this shit, and that is you. Check? And this is the key. We got to keep constantly reminding ourselves, and it's an ongoing process. You got to remind yourself every day that I am the Christ which is to come, which the Holy Kabbalah tell you that you are. You see what I'm saying? And start thinking like a god and all. So now, let's go on. Another movie came out, Blue Skies, to show you the cult of America. Movie with Jessica Lange and Tommy Lee Jones. And the movie is dealing with, they dropped some nuclear testing on, there was nuclear testing in the 50s or whatever. And they saw there was two people that was farming out there on the horses. And they didn't tell the people to get out of the way, and they dropped the bomb anyway, and these people start coming out with all kind of stuff. So when Jessica Lange came out to tell the two people that the government is the one that is the reason for them coming down with all these ailments and this nuclear stuff, they said one thing in the movie. He said, no, my government didn't say they did this. And until my government says that that's what happened, I have to believe what the government says. Or I can't believe that the government will do this. That's showing you the brainwashing techniques in America. So it's interesting. So movies like these that come out, it's small things, but it's major things also, too. Check? It's major things also, too. Now, what is the deal? Now, the new shit is the drugs and the CIA. Mm-hmm. All that is a new plot to get you from thinking the other way. First of all, it's not the conscious people that knew this. Every fool from Alabama, Georgia, and down Mississippi knew that the government planted the drugs. Hell, I go to Mullins and people say, well, you know, you know the whole thing. We ain't got no boats, no planes, and all. We've been saying that for 10 years. So everybody knew that the government is the one that planted the damn drugs in the community. You understand what I'm saying? Everybody knew this. They've had black, so-called, quote-unquote, black exploitation flicks that dealt with that. So why is it now all of a sudden we're so crazy until we couldn't take action 10 years ago, we got to wait till the white man validates it? Now, let's not be stupid with this mess. First of all, the government got shit that they did 100 years ago that you don't know about. Or you will find out 100 years later. You say, mm-mm-mm. It was bad how they dropped them smallpox on the Indians and all this kind of shit. So you know damn well if the government, the way they are, whereas they can kill everybody that even think, hell, they can... If a person comes up and breaks some news in the newspaper, they can come in and jack that nigga up and put some and put some electrodes under his balls and some razor blades up his ass, and he'll print a retraction the next day. So obviously, if this particular information is getting out, but they got information that will never get out. You understand what I'm saying? If this particular information is getting out where they put it on the news, and the news is run by the government, that means that the government is the one that is behind putting this information out. Now all the black bourgeoisie Negroes is running up to Washington, D.C. You see what I'm saying? And that's the reason why, so when you found out, hell, Farrakhan told them about that 10 years ago at Northwestern University, that the government is the number one funder of the government is damn dope. Any fool know this, but you mean to tell me, now here it is, this is the sickness of it, because it's all a test. You so sick that you can't damn stand up as grown people, as spiritual people, and say, hell, we know the deal. Back in 1988, 1986, 1987, and 1990 when you finally realized the shit. We know the deal that you're the one that's putting it in. No, you got to wait till the damn white man documents it. And he always put the shit out. He always documents it 10 years too late. Too late now? You don't even know who. Hell, half the people could be dead. Hell, all the black people already in jail. Half of them dead now. Half of them will never be no.